have a clinical and a research interest in inflammatory arthritis that develops as a result of immune checkpoint inhibitor treatment of cancer. In patients who get immune checkpoint inhibitors, about 5% will develop arthritis, actual inflammation in the joints, although closer to 14 or 15% will get joint pains.
So when I first started seeing these patients, I thought we really need more information about them. We need to get that information out to the public. I thought it would be great to develop a system where we keep track of these patients, we know what they're going through, we know what conditions they're developing.
So about a year and a half ago, we established a registry so that we could, in a formal way, begin to collect information about our patients.
When we started this, we didn't even know how often does it happen. Which joints does it affect? Does it respond to this treatment or that treatment? So we didn't really have a good sense of that.
Being able to collect a large cohort or a registry of patients, which is what we have here, is really critical to have the numbers to be able to generalize and begin to learn what does it look like, what's causing it, how to, you know, what is the best way to treat it.
If it's a mild case, we might be able to get away with a little bit of steroid. We have been using things like methotrexate, so that the non-biologic DMARDs have been useful. And then some in severe cases, we will use biologics such as infliximab or tocilizumab.
We know how to treat arthritis pretty well, autoimmune arthritis. We have lots of medicines available, and we know well how to use those outside of the cancer setting. But if you've just given a cancer patient medication to stimulate their immune system, and then your treatment is suppressing the immune system, you worry that you might be interfering with the anti-cancer effects. So trying to figure out what the best treatments are that will control the arthritis without interfering with the anti-cancer effects is really the holy grail.